Hello, this is Jerry Jenkins. This is a video I'm going to tell you about 10 keyboard shortcuts that are new to Windows 11, and so they're very useful. The first half of them, actually five of them, have to do with tiling your windows, and we're going to cover those. One is the Windows key, Alt, Arrow key, and the other is the Windows Z, and they both allow you to tile your windows in different ways. So let's go see how this works. So I have three windows here, and so the simplest thing you can do is whatever the current window is that you select, you can hold down the Windows key, Alt, and use one of the arrow keys. So I'm going to use the right arrow key, and you'll see it snaps it over to the right. If I use the up arrow key, it snaps it to the top half of the display. If you use the left arrow key, it snaps it to the left side. And if you use the down arrow key, it snaps it down to the bottom. So that's using the four arrow keys. Now what happens when you do that is if you have other windows, it says, well, which one do you want to put in the other half? So if you select one of them, like this famous photographs, it then makes that the top half, and the window I put in the bottom half stays where it was. But what happened to the third window is actually behind them. And you can kind of see that. Another feature is when you've done this, the windows are kind of connected. So if you go right in the middle, you'll see that double-headed arrow on the mouse, and you can drag down. You kind of see the window back there behind it. But this is another feature. You can give more or less space to the top or bottom window. This works the same way if I snapped this top window to the left, doing a Window Alt left arrow, and I put the paint program on the right. You can go between them, and you can allocate more space to the paint program, or you can allocate more space to the other one. Now there are some caveats about this on Windows. Some programs, apps, won't let the window shrink below a certain size, so it won't behave very well with this tiling scheme, I've noticed. It's something hopefully Microsoft will figure out eventually. Part of the reason it's having on, I'm on a laptop that's fairly small, and I've enlarged my font size and everything a little bigger for my videos, so it compounds the problem. Okay, so let's look at the other key. So the other key is the Windows and the Z key. So you just hold down Windows and hit Z, and you have to be on your current window, Windows Z, and you'll see it pops down this little thing here. So this is another way to tile things. So you can say, well, I want this pattern of tile, which is actually the same as going left or right. And this gives you a little more room, say to the left and right. This is putting four windows in, and here's three windows. So maybe I want the paint program to be here. And then there's this window left, so I want to put that up there. And then the last one left, I say there. So now it's arranged my three windows, and you can go between them and also rearrange them just like this. And again, things can get a little wonky if it won't decrease the size of the window because the app is preventing it, so it starts to behave strange. So that's basically what you can do with tiling. Tiling is great because I always had trouble getting the windows so I could see them all. So I'm actually trying to switch between them and move them around, and one's covering up the other, and it just seems like a lot of work in Windows. So this is a great feature that they've added to Windows. So now the next shortcuts are kind of cool. So the first thing is I'm going to go to Notepad here. So, and I'm going to, let's make it big. Okay, and the next command we're going to use, I've expanded Notepad to fill the screen. And you'll see there's a blinking cursor here that I can start typing, so I can say hello. But if you're like me and you're just a terrible typist, you might want to just do dictation. And so you do the window key H, and this will start a mic listening, and it'll start typing everything you say. Period. New line. New line. And you can use special formatting keys like new line and period. And it will type these out. Period. And then do Windows H. And it'll stop listening. To find out everything you can do with it, just go down to the little question mark on the mic down here, and you can read about it. There's all types of commands you can give it when you're editing, and you can say special things to get all kinds of punctuation symbols. So go ahead and read this. You can even switch to different languages, so you can speak in French or whatever. And so it's a kind of a cool thing that would save you a lot of typing. Okay, so let's go on to the next thing we're going to do, and this is the screencasting. So the screencasting used to be you'd go down here and you'd click, and there was this shortcut panel which showed you things that you could click on connect, and it would go to you could connect to a smart TV. So they now have a shortcut for that, because you can't find it. You have to, it's somewhere in the control panel, and you can search for casting and probably find it. But all you have to do is hold down the Windows key and type K. Give it a minute. It'll search for any TVs you've allowed to be visible. So you probably have to set up your smart TV to say, yes, you can accept casting. And now it's showing me places I can cast to. So I can choose one of those, and it will cast my whole screen. This is great if you're presenting to a group in your room. You can basically use your TV as like a big projector, and it'll mirror what you have on your screen to the TV. It's not really good for watching video because it doesn't seem to have the bandwidth, so you can watch video, but it's really broken up a little bit. Sound is okay, but the video is so-so. Maybe if you have a really, really fast Wi-Fi, maybe it'll work, but I haven't gotten it to work good. Okay, so the next one, I have three that are just open up different panels and control panels inside Windows that are useful. So the next one is WinA. So let me cancel the cast with an escape, and I'll say WinA. And this brings up the shortcuts. So it's basically to set your volume and your brightness of your screen, and it has some other things. Focus Assistant is a thing that you can set what notifications will bother you when you're working on something. You can also change your Wi-Fi up here. You can enter airplane mode, which turns off your Wi-Fi and all your radio stuff and so on. So it gives you some information here. Shows you your battery percentage. So that's one shortcut. Let me hit Escape to get out of that. The next one is WinN. WinN gives you your notifications and calendar. So if you want to check your calendar really quick without using your mouse, you just do WinN from anywhere you are, the Windows key in, and it'll pop up your calendar. I'll hit Escape to get out of that. And the last one is to open the widgets. You hold down the Windows key and a W for widgets, and it opens up your widgets. So this is a really fast way to get your widgets, the check the latest news, see what the temperature is outside, check your stock if you're doing stuff like that. So you can, of course, customize your widgets, but that's a video for another day. So thank you. These are 10 nice new shortcuts that are part of Windows 11.